Well, we're here to look at some episodes, some sad episodes of what we believe to be illegal tree poisoning. We've got behind me on the foreshore a patch which was well vegetated and which is now just showing significant loss of trees, and that's currently under investigation for poisoning. And in front of me up on the ridge, we have a similar problem with some quite mature eucalypt that have died recently, and again we're investigating that because we believe this is another case of illegal poisoning. It's particularly concerning. I mean, it's a criminal offence, first of all. But in the area behind me, we have a very narrow foreshore. It's only, you know, 3 or 4 metres between the roadway and the beach. It's vegetated for a very good reason, that we want to maintain that foreshore. We want to keep the beach together. To the west of here, we've already had to shift the road twice over the last 20 or 30 years because of erosion. And here we have very little buffer to play with. The same thing is going to happen.
Well, I think it's very sad that in such a interesting place with so much vital wildlife, there's green turtles out here at Gattagers, which anybody putting a boat in probably would have seen. Of course, there's the beautiful birds. We can see there that banksias have died. Well, the parrots and the yellow-tailed black cockatoos feed on those banksias. There's she-oaks, horse-tailed she-oaks, that are look like they're on the way out. And they're very important because they add nitrogen to the soil, and the rainbow lorikeets and other parrots eat the seeds. So it's a very wildlife-rich and diverse area, and it's a shame to see that it's threatened by killing of vegetation. And also it will probably affect the human population as well when the erosion occurs, because as we all know, even school children know that trees on a slope stop erosion.
Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't want people coming onto your property spreading poison around, and really this foreshore belongs to everyone, and someone up here that very selfishly has decided that, you know, spreading poison is the best way of getting rid of the trees, so they get a better views.
My message is that you ought to have some respect for your community, have some respect for your neighbours, have some respect for the council and the ratepayer who have to foot the bill of fixing this up. The esplanade doesn't belong to the house that sits just on the esplanade. It belongs to everybody, and we've got to maintain the esplanade as an attractive place for everybody. We're going to have to look at some revegetation here, and in fact it's got to the stage where we're going to have to look at some fairly drastic action, perhaps putting up large barriers to protect the new vegetation. We settled one damages claim against another resident a year or so ago for $20,000, and so figures of that order are not out of, not beyond the range of possibilities at all. We take it very seriously. As I say, we are currently investigating, and we'll continue to do that, and where there is evidence, we'll prosecute.